I have some thoughts about YouTube. Good morning! Welcome to Vlogmas Day 3! It's a little after 7. I've been in bed, just not feeling like getting out of bed and getting the day started. So I was all cozy. Alright, day 3. What are we gonna have? Oh my gosh, it's pink. How cute. Oh my gosh, you guys, look at today's coffee. What is that? It's from Ethiopia. So I wear my Fitbit to sleep every night, and it analyzes my sleep. It tells me when I woke up, if I was restless, tossed and turned, how many hours I got. So last night, I fell asleep at 10:57, so basically 11, and I woke up at 6:30. They gave me an 84 out of 100 for my sleep score. That's decent. Not bad. I did wake up later today. Hey guys, it's a little after 8, so I've been working for a little bit. And I didn't show my whole coffee and water thing. You guys saw it for the past 2 days. Just the same routine this morning. Gonna get some work done. I'm hoping to work a longer day today, just like yesterday. Because again, we're trying to take Friday, work half a day Friday without having to take any leave. So I'm thinking if I can get at least 8.5 to 9 hours in today, we'll be solid. So that's the goal. What are these? Is this a robocall? Hello?
Is this Esma?
No, it's not. I think you have the wrong number.
But you don't, okay. All right, I'm calling from the endoscopy center. We have a patient that's had a procedure, and I'm just trying to get a hold of his person.
So. Oh, yeah, that's not that, me.
Okay, all right.
Sorry.
All right.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Wow, somebody had an endoscopy.
They ain't gonna get their result.
It's 10 a.m., so I have my little snack of cut-up strawberries that I'm gonna dip in some raspberry yogurt. Since I finally went grocery shopping, I can actually eat something good for my body. I washed my face, did my whole facial routine. So yeah, y'all aren't missing much. That's the mid-morning update. All right, you guys, I just logged off for the day. Sorry to disappoint you guys, but I did not work a 9-hour day like I was really hoping. Today just lasted forever. It was just pretty low-key, boring day, so I couldn't sit there any longer. I need to run to the post office. I need to get Christmas stamps for my Christmas cards, assuming they have any left. I need to drop off the card that I wrote yesterday for my friend. Let me put on some pants and we'll go do that. You guys, I'm in a funky mood. So I'm wearing my Screamin' Sicilian toboggan that I got from the Screamin' Sicilian Pizza Company. I did a funny TikTok about them and they loved it and they sent me some free goodies. And then I'm wearing some cheetah print vest, Mount LeConte t-shirt, sweatpants, socks with sandals with Christmas socks. Let's go to the post office. The fact that I'm wearing a beanie again after yesterday's fiasco of making my head itch. I'm literally in the dark. There we go. So I've been doing some reflecting today while I've been working, and I got real deep in some thoughts about the real reflection of YouTube. Like, I have some thoughts about YouTube. I don't know if you care to hear them or not. It's just the simple fact that any YouTuber, including myself, I'm on YouTube. There's a point of narcissism to be a YouTuber. And I think that's point blank period. I think anyone would agree with that, because you're editing videos of yourself. You're talking to a camera. You think you're entertaining enough to not only entertain yourself, entertain other people. I think you can use your channel in a really good way. And I hope that I'm using my channel in a good way. I don't regret anything I've posted. As you grow and you have more subscribers, I think you feel more liked, or you're trying to please more people. And I think it just twists reality. I think it warps reality for some YouTubers. All this to say, as I was in this deep thought bubble, I feel like the Lord has really called me to make a YouTube channel. I definitely think that was a God thing. I know that may sound funny. For the CPA exam specifically, when I started my channel, I didn't know I was gonna be a CPA. And then going through that journey, the community of you guys that have encouraged me as I failed exam after exam, you are going way too slow, homie. I felt really encouraged from you guys, while also, in hindsight, encouraging others without even realizing it through my struggles of that exam, that a lot of you guys have emailed me, DM'd me on Instagram, commented on my videos about how inspiring that was, and it gives me purpose. It's really great. I want the purpose of my channel to be to help others and to help you guys as practically as I can, physically help you guys, but also just to be an example of an auditor or whatever I get myself into. I may not be an auditor forever. I don't know what the future holds. I mean, who knows? And my Africa trip, going on a huge 5-week-long mission trip, hoping that it happens. I can't cross my fingers on my right hand.
They're trying. They're really trying.
And that's the whole, like, adventure part of my channel. Just taking you guys along with my life adventure and whatever it may bring.
Honey, where is your blinker?
thoughts are just that I don't want to wake up one day and realize I've been pursuing the wrong things with my channel and my platform in general, social media, or any influence that I have on anybody. And I want to stay grounded in the faith for sure. That's my number one top priority, most important thing personally. And I just think it would be too easy to go down the wrong path and kind of become selfish. Even clickbait, some titles on some YouTube videos that make people click, we've all clicked on clickbait titles. It's deceiving. There's a whole thing about clickbait. I can't stand clickbait. But you get more views, you get more subscribers, and as you get more views, the algorithm favors you. The more videos you upload, you have more people watching. But anyways, I got to thinking about that today because I was just thinking about Vlogmas and how I wasn't really in a vlogging mood today. I didn't share a lot. It was just kind of really boring work day. So, but I was like, I'm not doing this for me. I'm doing this for you guys. You want to see the everyday boring stuff of an auditor? Anything you share online with anybody, you open yourself up to criticism for that, obviously. But the bigger you get on any internet, social media, anything, the more personal it gets too, because I don't know, there's a lot of mean trolls out there that are going to say everything about things that you don't really agree with or that you shared or something you may be passionate about. People are going to make fun of that. And you can't take it personally. Anytime I've told somebody that I have a YouTube channel, half the time people are like, oh my gosh, what is it? That's so awesome. I'll subscribe. Then the other half is like, what do you talk about on there? Judgment hardcore. And I totally get it. And that's totally fine. Anyways, that's my thoughts for the day. That's my thoughts on YouTube. Princess Parker.
Mine with the big old squiggly on it. All right, we got this and Rhode Island.
Oh my gosh, there was no line in there today. So I got some stamps. They had several options. I decided to go with these. I thought they were kind of cute. More mature, not like kitty Christmas. So I'm excited. I have to write my Christmas cards, you guys. Also, while we're here, so I got some stamps last week, like normal stamps at the grocery store. And I thought it was so cliche that the grocery store just gave me a bunch of food as the stamp. They didn't even ask me or nothing. That's just what they handed me. I thought it was hilarious. But I got this one from Rhode Island. It says Providence, but the person I think is from Greenville, Rhode Island. Oh my gosh, thank you so much, Tracy. One of the few people that actually put Heaven's Oddventure and not Adventure. Thank you so much. So kind. Oh my gosh, it's a whole card. I'm getting way too excited. So this came all the way from New Zealand. Oh my goodness. Look, it's like a postcard card. First of all, can we just say, dude, you've got the best handwriting. This handwriting is the font I need in my YouTube videos. Oh. Oh my gosh, you also sent stickers. How fun. Thank you so much, James. You guys are awesome. I was just talking about the whole purpose of my YouTube channel. Things are coming full circle already today. What are we gonna do now? Hello, guys, I gotta get gas and I pulled up on the wrong pump because my car used to have the pump on the passenger side. The gas tank, not the pump. The pump stays where the pump's at. I need my Kroger card so I can get the Kroger discount. Use them grocery points. Apparently I didn't have that many Kroger points. I only saved 3 cents to the gallon. But hey, it's something. All right, guys, since I'm already here at Kroger on accident, there's literally somebody over here pumping gas and I'm just talking to myself. I think I'm gonna make some Christmas haystacks. You know, the little not candy. They're not cookies, they're not candy. Dessert. So I'm gonna go run in here real quick and get that stuff. I got just shy of 11 gallons and it was just shy of $20. I know a lot of you guys are like super interested in the gas prices for some reason. I just got gas. I don't know where the price is. Oh, there it is. Okay, it's $1.88 right now here in Knoxville, Tennessee. If you do not live in the U.S., do not assume all United States has cheap gas like we do here. Absolutely not. We're just gonna take a... I didn't see her. Oh, look at this super old lady. So I just need 2 items. We'll see how it goes. Wish me luck. All right, I just made it back from the store. Kroger was selling these super cute Christmas tubs, which is perfect for, whoop, these haystacks I'm gonna make because I wanna take them on our trip this weekend, but I don't have a big enough Tupperware. So I saw these for $2. I was like, shoot. I made these with my grandma last year. I think I did a YouTube video on it. I don't really remember. And we may bake again this year. I don't know, but 2 ingredients, chow mein noodles and butterscotch. I had to go to 2 grocery stores for 2 items because Kroger didn't have any butterscotch. I poured a bag in a microwave safe bowl and we're just gonna start microwaving. So it's super melty. So now we add the noodles. I don't know the ratio. There's probably a recipe out there. All right, this is about half the can. I'd never even heard of these until last year when my grandma told me to stop by the bakery and pick up some butterscotch and then some Chinese noodles. I was like, huh? And we made these and they were really good. All right, here's 1 batch of haystacks and it perfectly finished the bowl. All right, I'm gonna make another batch of these. Here's batch number two. It's a bit uglier because I was doing it really fast while making the green beans really quick. My early dinner slash weird snack is served. Also went ahead and washed all them bad boys so I didn't have to dread that. I've got a belly full of green beans and I just clicked on Netflix and Virgin River season two is up. I did not know it was ready yet, so I'm gonna watch it. This is perfect timing so I can sign some Christmas cards while watching Virgin River. So I've got my little lap desk with some colorful pens. We are in the Christmas card signing zone. Fast forward over an hour later and I think I have 9 done. So this is my first batch. I have 2 batches left to write. We'll do that another day. Okay guys, let's taste one of the haystacks, shall we? I don't want a big one.
So I'm gonna eat this little small one. They're so good, you guys. I highly recommend making them.
Oh, you guys, it's a little after 8. I've been editing this Vlogmas that you guys are watching. So I'm gonna go ahead and end Vlogmas here so I can go ahead and get the video up. I still have to pack for this weekend's trip. I'll probably do that tomorrow. Tomorrow may be a little hectic and it's gonna be a little out of the past 3 days of routine because I am gonna be on a trip. I don't know how I'm gonna edit. We'll figure it out. Don't you guys worry. So I'll see you next time. Hopefully I still get a Vlogmas day 4 out on day 4, but we'll see. Anyways, I'll see you guys later.